Web versus mobile, which one to learn first?
This is definitely something that crossed my mind when I was first entering the tech industry is, what should I learn? Should I learn web development? Should I learn mobile development? There is so much to learn, I don't even know what to do. And it can become so overwhelming that it becomes almost like you are frozen where you don't learn anything because it's so overwhelming. As someone who's been a software developer for over 4 years, I'm going to talk to you today about my thoughts on where to begin if you are interested in both web and mobile development. Shout out to some, nope, that's the old one. What are we getting into? What are we leaving? Okay. Before we get into this video further, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Leave in the comments other topics, questions, feedback, anything you have for me, let me know in the comments. I love the community we are continuing to build, and I honestly every day take time to read through your comments as best I can. So I really do sit down and read them. So leave a comment for me. I want something good to read. Okay, let's just jump right into it. Before we get any further though, I want to share with you about a really cool tool called Filestack. Filestack is the number one developer service for file uploads. So it allows you to get user content from anywhere and improve file and video uploads with a powerful and easy to use API. This is an API that is super friendly to use, and I really wanted to share with you about it because if you are starting to build different projects or really looking for projects to showcase in your portfolio, this is a great way to showcase you using an API and to use it in a way that is very easy to integrate. With Filestack, it allows you to easily give your customers the power to adjust or manipulate their images before they upload them. So it allows your customers to transfer, adjust, or apply a beautiful filter to their images. I linked Filestack down below in the description, so make sure to click on it. You can sign up for free, play around with it to see how it works, and integrate it into your next project. Okay, let's get going. Okay, well, before we get into it though, let's talk about the tech stack required for either. If you are learning web development or considering learning web development, here are some common languages you will need to know, or may need to know, not necessarily all of them. Of course, you'll need to know CSS, HTML, then there's Python, PHP, JavaScript, Ruby. I mean, there's tons more, but those are just some of the popular ones. Depending on your background and your previous experience, web development can be pretty easy to pick up. And let me just say easy. I understand if you're someone who has no coding experience, it is much more difficult. But over time, like JavaScript was my first language and I found it to be pretty simple to learn. It gets more complex as you add on frameworks and then dive into the backend, etc. But it's a great entryway. Then, if you're interested in mobile development, you really need to look at what kind of mobile development you are interested in. Do you want to build Android products? Do you want to build iOS products? And based on that, the languages will vary. One of the things I think that can be very confusing to people is they want a really good paying job. They want the job that's most in demand. And I feel really comfortable saying that all three areas are very in demand. So really focus on, don't focus on the salary that comes with each job, but focus on where your interest lies. And if you don't know, I think the best way to know is simply to start practicing and diving into it. This is not good. For me, how I just started diving into it and understanding where I really wanted to start was through taking different tutorials online. When I started to learn how to code, of course, installed VS Code and started playing around with building different JavaScript web applications. And then I also downloaded Xcode and started playing around with Swift and getting familiar with that application development side. And I found I gravitated more towards the web side of things to start with. And I think it was because it was an easier entry point for me. I just found like things were clicking quicker and I was seeing much more quicker progress. And I knew that if I learned web first, I could still always go back and learn mobile, which I have. I'm a horrible mobile developer though. I very rarely do it. But if someone needs an application built, I can be your person. And starting with web for me made the entry into tech and coding easier. And I think that a lot of people find that, but if you're very passionate about mobile, it's another great way to go. Well, let's talk about demand now. Which is more in demand? And I don't want to necessarily share specific stats on that because it really varies based on where you are located. So I could share stats with you that web is way more in demand in, say, North America, but then if you live in Europe, it might be completely different. So my best suggestion for you is to simply just Google what is more in demand in wherever the country you are and see what comes up. Now, once again, though, even if mobile is more in demand than web and vice versa, it really shouldn't be your deciding factor. I think both of these roles are so in demand that having one or the other based on salary or based on in demand shouldn't really be your reason, because at the end of the day, they both will pay really well and they both are in demand. And if you are in a location where maybe the jobs around you don't pay as well or they aren't as in demand, start looking for remote jobs. Now there are so many remote positions, and I think it's one of the best things that has happened these past few years in tech is just the demand and push for remote jobs and hiring from anywhere in the world. So don't let necessarily your location as well be your main focus as to what path you choose. Okay, but what about the learning curve? This is something I think is very important. And as I've kind of alluded to throughout this video, from my experience, I found web development easier to learn, especially when starting out. But when you really think of everything you need to learn for web development, there's a lot more, it seems like, right out the gate that you need to learn versus for web development, for mobile development. For web development, as I mentioned, you need to learn HTML, CSS, and then pick a programming language. Do you want to learn JavaScript, Python? Do you want to do more backend with PHP? What do you want to focus on? But I always say for web development, even if you want to do backend, starting with CSS and HTML, although they aren't programming languages, are a great place to start, just to start getting used to coding to some degree. Whereas if you look at mobile, for Android, you're more focused on learning one thing, which is Kotlin. And if you're focused on iOS, maybe you're focused on learning Swift. So it seems like, those two seem easier to pick up because it's just one specific area versus web, where there seems to be a lot of things to learn. But here's where I think it gets tricky. When you are developing in mobile, there still are a lot of concepts that you learn in web you will have to apply in mobile. For example, you will still have to learn to interact with the backend and the databases and APIs and how that all works. And that's similar to what you'll have to learn in web. Now, it might be a bit different based on application and programming language, etc., but you're still going to have to learn a lot of that stuff in order to make you really a proficient developer. Okay, so that's my thoughts on whether you should learn web or mobile. And I know I didn't give you a specific clear answer, and the reason for that is intentional. It's because that's not my place to decide for you. But from my experience and sharing my story, I would start with web, because even if you do end up going into mobile, there are so many concepts from web that you will have to take over that I think starting with web is a great place to start. However, mobile is a bit more niche, and if that's kind of the area you are really interested in, I think you really need to just dive into where your interests lie. Thank you all for watching this video. I hope you found it very valuable and helpful in deciding which is right for you. Is it web? Is it mobile? I'm curious to know, though, what path you decide on, so leave in the comments below. And I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.